Breathe, big guy. Breathe.
Sorry. Boy, you're trying to beat you through.
It's okay. Get him off. Come on. Keep going. Keep going.
Do you see how my body is? And the reason why I'm doing that is not because I couldn't have started like this. Go now. Oh, it's hard to breathe right there.
Yeah.
Sorry, Cap. Thank you for volunteering. But I know who else wants to try. You know what I know? I know that in the real world, I might have my perfect grip, but something might force me to let go. Including my
frustrating.
It's almost not most fair if I get too ready. I need to be. A neck hug.
Need to go home. Don't get arrested. Backup will be here in 45, 35 seconds.
See, my focus is to be on top. A little bit of guard retrieval. I don't want guard. So I fight the leg out. Back on top. Back on top. Sorry. Back on top. Just stay on top. How often does the officer so attacked? So feel figure like they hold on, and then they're actually very typical. Right? So this is not something you're gonna learn right now. Well, what is it? Four, what's happening? Four. Side mount. Neck. Control the shoulder a little bit for space and turning. Maybe grab his leg right here as an anchor. Maybe switch sides. Cut this tricep. When the mount made sense right here, so I mount it. But now I'll dismount and I'll go back to the side. And I'll just keep pressure. And I'll go back in the neck. I got another elbow. Ah.
It's gonna be heat on in 65 cops video.
Bad guy. Oh man.
So knowing when you can hold on to somebody to keep yourself over them, but if they do a big random twist and you stay attached, that can be what leads putting you in the bottom of the fight. Which again, is it a problem? No. Especially if you, you know, spend time on them. Anybody else looking to go?
All right.
Two for one, two for one.
I'm
tired, but what's keeping you down? Yeah.
Go home. One of you, I could have been a lot more locked on, but what are the risks of being too locked on?
Might get bumped, top bumped.
You might get rolled. Now we showed you when somebody bumps, hand, bumps, leg is bent, weapon, sit through, back to bump, hand, back to standard, back to leg. We showed you that. But we can't teach you the in-between. Like how many positions did I land in or do that we didn't cover today? Everyone! Every single thing that I did. So it just comes with experience in playing the game. And how enjoyable is it to have myself with three or four other black belts, and we only do a drill where the bottom person has to get out in 1 minute and top person only hold. It's the best game of all times. Especially when it's very equal, because then you keep one down, they escape two, right? It becomes very, I'm bigger than you guys, most of you, and more experienced, so therefore I'm able to keep you down. But if you had the same level of experience, and maybe more size, and youth on me, then I would be surprised. A lot, I guess I lose the time on a lot. But so me being half connected is me preparing for what? When my partner, when the person that I'm controlling, creates space that puts me in that half-connected place. Does that make sense?
Yes, sir.
And it's very likely you get pushed there. I don't care how good you are. You're gonna hold someone down, and no matter how ready you think you are, you're gonna bump, twist, and turn. You're gonna lose your grips. You're gonna lose your footing. So what do? Grab a hamstring. Hug the neck. You improvise. You grab whatever you can, you make it happen, keep them down. Even if they put you in the guard, keep them down. They roll to their knees, you stay on top. They roll again, you release, stay on top. Always on top. Good. Can we just have a break right now?
That was a break.
That was a break. That was a good break. Double underhook guard pass.